Come in.
Hello.
Hello.
How y'all doing?
Good.
I'm Dr. Jordan, and you're?
Michael Blair.
Michael Blair, and this young lady is?
This is my wife, Kimberly.
Well, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So where are you coming from?
Conroe.
Conroe, Texas. All right. So, Michael, you're over 600 pounds, huh?
Mm-hmm.
And you're here to lose weight, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. So what led you to come here to get help with that today?
Last chance. I've tried to contact doctors. I've contacted numerous surgeons because I've got extensive scar tissue. It's from my emergency splenectomy. And no surgeon wants to cut in because they say that there's no hope.
How much you weighed when you had that?
380.
Huh?
I was 380 pounds.
380 pounds?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it looked like you have quite a situation. All this thing happened to you. Do you have a goal at this point?
The only goal I have left is to find a surgeon that is willing and able to cut through my scar tissue and actually perform the surgery. Because I've tried every diet out there. Nothing has worked.
So what seems to be the biggest challenge with your eating habit?
It's the amount that it takes to sate me. It's like I can't just have one chicken breast.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's like if I have a bowl of rice, my bowl of rice can be two or three cups of rice at a time. So it's just empty carbs. Or it'll be pasta. It'll be a pound of pasta.
Okay. If you say you eat healthy, but you just eat too much of it, then why can't you stop eating?
I don't know. That's the question. I can't stop because I, at some point, I think maybe it became a defense mechanism because I was so abused and tortured as a child, just in society. It's hard for me to go out. I have agoraphobia. So it's extremely hard for me to be out in public because I don't really like people. I hate society.
So at what age did you decide that?
I realized I didn't like people when I was about 8 or 9. Once I realized that I was always going to be picked on.
So at any point, did you have any therapy or see any?
I've had lots of therapy.
So with all these things, not liking people, having difficulty in it, how in the world did you get such a supporting wife? How did you find that?
I met him.
Funny. Humor. I can hide my pain through humor.
But could it be that you don't give too much opportunity for people to know you? And if they know you, maybe they like you?
Absolutely. I've been hurt so many times by people that I don't want people to get to know me.
So if you were today 220 pounds, do you think your outlook of going with people will change?
Oh, 100%.
So the issue is the perspective you're adopting on things, where you make excuses and blame everyone for the reason you don't want to be around them. But this all comes down to your weight being the issue. So do you think you can make some changes in your eating habit? Are you motivated to do that?
I am 100% motivated.
Well, you know, you're going to have to make some changes.
Done.
And
done and done.
Bite the bullet and control your eating habit. And it's going to be
done.
Something that you're going to have to do to get to that point.
Done and done.
Okay.
You know.
Well, here's what I want you to do. I'm going to set you to see a therapist and see if they can help you get some of the level of anxiety that you have down, because you have built so many baggage in your life at this point, and you become so very opinionated about where you are and how the world is. Maybe we can change that, okay?
I hope.
So this is gonna be something that's important to do.
Okay.
Because your perspective on things needs to improve for you to have any chance to do this for the long run. But we got a lot of work to do, get to the point that will be even feasible to try and see if there is a possibility to do any kind of surgery on you. So the first thing is going to be that you need to start losing weight now. So we're going to try to change your eating habit and see if we can get some discipline in what you're eating and try to get weight down. And then I'm going to set you up to have some tests and do endoscopy and weight loss surgery. But you have a food comfort. So everything that you see that is dark in front of you, when you eat, you can get a little bit better.
Yeah.
So that food comfort is going to be an issue, because even if you do weight loss surgery, how are you going to deal with those anxieties?
Yeah.
If you don't learn to deal with that in a healthy way, you still go back to food and undo the surgery, it will be pointless in the long run. And that's going to be a significant issue that we need to work out,
yes.
Okay? So you're going to do some blood tests on you today. But I'm going to set you up to have some more tests done on your heart and your lung and examine your scar tissue and what's going on in your abdomen and see what is the ability for you to have any kind of surgery down the road.
Okay.
But this is something that I want you to focus on changing your life at this point. You're going to have to try hard and follow the instruction and be more proactive for your health. And this is the only way we can get you out of this situation.
Yeah.
Okay?
Okay.
And I had gastric bypass 15 years ago, and so I will be whatever you need for support-wise for him.
Well, that's good. But so far, whatever his environment is, he's still able to get what he wants and overeat. So that unhealthy support system needs to change.
Okay.
So the diet is going to limit the amount to eat in a day to 1,200 calories. But a focus on protein and avoiding almost all carbs.
Okay.
And I want your focus to be on losing as much weight as you can right now and getting your stamina. But I'm not going to give you a specific goal until we do the endoscopy, okay?
Okay.
But all those things is going to be all up to you at this point. I want you to forget about what the past is and look forward to future. So this is a new day. You're going to start a new way of eating, a new way of exercising and changing everything. We got a lot of work to do.
Yeah.
We're willing to do it. You tell us what to do and we'll do it.
All right. So I'm going to bring you some instruction that I mentioned. Then we'll set up an appointment for you to go to therapy.
Okay.
So just try to change the course of the life that you have right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
If he's able to change that, will you think, I mean, is it possible, do you think, to attempt the surgery if all the tests say?
From what Michael said, most likely we're going to face a lot of scar tissue and a lot of issues. So we have to look at that issue first to see what's possible and if weight loss surgery can be done or not. So if everything looks good and he loses weight, we can try doing surgery on him. Okay?
Okay.
You got your yes. Is it possible?
But this is all going to be
dependent
if it's safe to have surgery.
Yeah.
Okay? But you have to bite the bullet and do the hard work.
Fine. Done and done.
In the meantime, we're going to see if we can draw some blood. I'll give you some instruction about your diet and exercise. All right, let me see if we can draw some blood on you.
Thank you.
Okay, all right, I'll be back.
Okay, thank you.
We obviously have a lot of issues we need to address with Michael to get him on the right track with his overall health, especially with his mentality and perspective. He seems to have a lot of negative views on things and people that is leading to a lot of anxiety with him. So starting him going to psychotherapy right now will be important to help him start to work on that. But the big question seems to be what the situation is in his abdomen with the scar tissue that prevented his previous attempt at weight loss surgery. So we need to run some tests to determine that, because if weight loss surgery isn't a possibility for him, we'll have to adapt the program and how we approach giving Michael the tools he needs to get healthy. Because it's very important he start to lose a lot of weight before he develops any more health issues.